In this video, I will show you the most common patterns of logic you can find in a matrix across its rows, columns, and diagonals. In this example, the logic here is governed by the change in color, fill, and pattern of the shapes throughout the matrix. If we take a look at our 1-5-9 diagonal, we can see that all three of these elements share the same pattern. They have horizontal stripes. If we look at the rest of the elements in our 1-5-9 diagonal pattern, we should see that elements 2, 6, and 7 share a polka dot pattern. Then the last group of three, elements 3, 4, and 8, all share a solid black pattern. Sometimes the underlying logic can govern how many shapes or features are present in each element. Some common examples of this include changes to the number of edges of any given shape, the number of curved versus straight lines, the number of shapes within or outside of other shapes, and the number of lines. In this example, the number of shapes is governed by the logic of our rows and the logic of our columns. If we take a look at the logic in our rows, we can see that the same number of shapes is present in each element throughout the entire row. In the top row, there are 5 shapes in each element. In the middle row, there are 4, and in the bottom row, there are 3. From top to bottom in each of our columns, we are removing one of the white shapes. If we start in our left column, we get rid of one of the white shapes between our first two elements, namely the top right one. Then we get rid of the other remaining white element between the second and the third element of that column. The same thing is true of column 2. We get rid of the right white element, and then we get rid of the left white element, or the bottom white element. Again, in column 3, we get rid of the top right, and then we get rid of the one on the bottom. Rotations and flips are very common logic patterns. Usually, the entire element will rotate in the same direction, but it is possible for only certain parts of the element to rotate, or for different parts of the same element to be rotating in two different ways. In these types of matrix problems, the elements can either be rotated clockwise or counterclockwise. If you were to look at the face of a clock, clockwise is following the natural movement of the hands on the clock, to the right, down, and around. So if a shape in a matrix is rotating in that same pattern, it is rotating clockwise. Counterclockwise would be if the hands on the clock moved in the opposite way they were supposed to. If you started from the top of the clock and went left, down, and around, that would be clockwise. Rotations can also be done in different degrees. If I were to take this triangle, the three most common rotations are 45 degrees, which looks like this, 90 degrees, which would look like this, and 180 degrees, which would look like this. You can also do something that is called a flip, and flips can be both horizontal and vertical. Let me actually zoom out just a little bit. A horizontal flip would look like this. And a vertical flip would look more like this. Sometimes it's very easy to confuse flips with 180 degree rotations because, again, I'll show you on this triangle up here, when we rotated it 180 degrees, it looks about the same as a horizontal flip. What you have to do in questions like this, where you're trying to debate whether it was a 180 degree rotation or a flip, you really have to pay attention to the shape. Pay attention to any special patterns or shadings that could clue into whether it was a flip, like it was looking into a mirror, or if it was just rotated. In this example, the rotation of the elements is governed by the logic of our columns. If we take a look at each column from top to bottom, we can see that each element is being rotated 90 degrees clockwise, shown here. If I take the first element in column 1 and rotate it 90 degrees, it matches the element right below it. If I take the next element and then rotate it 90 degrees, it now matches the element right below it in that same column. If we do the same thing for the second column, the first element rotated 90 degrees will match the second element. And the second element of the column rotated 90 degrees again will match the third element in that column. And finally, the same thing goes for the third column. The first element is rotated 90 degrees to match the second element, and the second element is rotated 90 degrees to match the third element. Sometimes the underlying logic can govern how aspects of the elements may move or change. Some common examples of this are shapes getting closer together or farther apart, shapes increasing or decreasing in size, shapes appearing or disappearing, shapes moving within the frame of the elements, and shapes becoming thicker or thinner. In this example, there are two different types of movements affecting the elements from left to right in our rows. The black area in each element is expanding to the right and covering up the gray area. So, from left to right in each of our rows, black is slowly becoming the more dominant color and pushing that gray color away. From top to bottom in our columns, parts of the shape are disappearing. First, we're getting rid of this top right corner, as you can see here. Then, we are getting rid of some of the bottom right corner and then some more of that top left corner to give us our third element in each column. The same is true for all of the other elements. First, get rid of this corner, then get rid of a little bit from either side, and you will get the shape in the third element. And the same is true for our third column as well. The shape within each element may change in various ways. The entire shape itself could change, like a circle becoming a square. The structure of the lines may change, like a solid line becoming a dotted line, or a very thick line becoming a thin line. Or the ending of these lines could change, like an arrowhead becoming a bullet point, or the line ending in nothing at all. In this example, all of the elements in each column are the same shape. In the first column, we have circles. In the middle column, we have squares, or rectangles. And in the third column, we have pentagons. Then each row is changing the format of each of these shapes. The middle row is the original shape, unaltered. The top row is compressing the shapes, making them shorter and wider, while the bottom row is stretching the shapes, making them taller and thinner.